I'm Dr. Lisa Reynolds. I'm the principal of Detroit School of Arts.
Castech is on a roll with national awards, and today, another one. One of its teachers is headed to the White House with a shot at winning the National Teacher of the Year Award.
I auditioned for a group that was a performing arts summer youth program, and I really wanted to sing, but I found out my singing abilities weren't that good. But I had taken a dance class in middle school, and I really, really liked it. And so I knew that I was very comfortable on stage and performing and expressing myself through music, through movement. And the singing group that I was in, we auditioned, I choreographed the whole thing. So I always, you know, it was sort of like that was my gift, but I didn't know that was my gift until I actually started taking classes. I started with Clifford Fears, who's a professional dancer with Katherine Dunham Company. He had just come off tour. He was living here in Detroit, so I studied with him for 7 years. When I graduated high school, I went to Wayne State University. I auditioned and was in the advanced classes as a freshman. I dropped out of college and got married and traveled around the world. I had my own dance studio, and I was a performing artist, performing solo work and choreographing. And I moved back to Detroit in the early 90s. At that time, I was a choreographer for music videos for rappers, and that's where I met my husband, who was a videographer and director. And about a few years after that, I went to Specs Howard School of Broadcast Arts. I got my broadcast certificate. And then I went back to college, and this time I went to Mary Grove College. And my first year there, I actually met, danced with, and performed for Miss Katherine Dunham herself. So it was really full circle. I got my undergraduate degree in dance, minored in humanities, studied abroad in West Africa, and then my master's in education.
Bringing. I went to Wayne State University, and I was doing so well in the political science class, a professor partnered with me with some gentlemen from Lebanon, and we were in a study group together, and they one day asked me what I was. I thought that was strange. I eventually learned to say human. But I said, I'm black. And they said, no, you're not. And I said, yes, I am. And we argued back and forth. And I said, what makes you think that I don't know who I am or what I am? And they said, because you don't act like the people on Fred Sanford. And I had to teach them that black people are not monolithic.
From Detroit, being African-American, things like tuck your butt is something that's said in a lot of classes, but when you analyze it, you recognize that that's pretty racist and it's saying that you should try to make it disappear. When if you really tuck it, then your pelvic girdle is tilted and you're out of alignment. So the real thing would be to make your body in alignment, you know, to stack the spine so that it's straight. But we hear things like tuck your butt, or if you are maybe a more brown skin dancer, wear pink tights, and then you look funny because you got on pink tights and everybody else has on pink tights, but your arms are brown and your leg. So things like that, you know, come up in conversations. So what I've had to learn is that, you know, and then the emphasis on ballet as being better and then everything else is axillary is really not true. And as the more education you get, the more research you do, you recognize that it's just, that's one culture, that's one way of looking at things. And then there's these other cultures and have their way of looking at things, because every group of people on the planet has danced. You go anywhere on the planet, you're going to find people, you're going to find dance. So the fact that in an American society, we kind of made a hierarchy over certain things are better than, above, and then we buy into that. And when we buy into that, we demean ourselves, because we know and recognize that all people dance. Even hip hop dance is a form of expression that young people came up with that's validly theirs. And then you look around and you're like, everybody's doing it. But when you were doing it, it was, you know, looked down upon. So those things happen, and the older you get, the more mature you get, and the more research you do, the more you're able to articulate when someone is encroaching on you with racist ideas, to reject that, to do it in a way that provides knowledge and information, and then to flourish.
I'm fighting for free, quality public education for all children, regardless of who your parents are or where you live, but for all children.
I would like for you to get your teacher certification, and I would love you to come back to Detroit Public Schools Community District, because currently we are building and rising and investing into the arts programming, and we're going to need qualified dancers, artists, musicians that get their teaching certificate and come back and be the next generation. Because I went to DPS and I was exposed to dance and music and art, and I had some amazing teachers. And so now it's time for the young people to come back and reinvest in the city, because the city is willing to reinvest in the school district in terms of the district wanting to support the arts. So you have a home here, and I want you to get your education and come back so I can retire.